Definitely, it matters the kind of cricket that we play as a side. We're always playing for results, and that's something that the crowds always want to see. So, you know, they want to see test matches getting to a conclusion, not ending in, you know, boring draws and stuff like that. Even if it's a draw, it has to be a competitive one. So that's something that the crowd wants to see, and that's the kind of cricket that we have provided over the past few months, and that's why we see so many people come in and want to watch this Indian team play, because they understand what they're going to get on the field, and it's not going to be the kind of cricket that's not going to take the game anywhere. It's going to be, you know, played with a vision to win, and that's exactly what the crowd wants, and that's why the connect is made between the players and the crowd as well. See, Jadeja, we as a team don't, you know, think of these things at all, that everyone's playing in Ashwin's shadow. Everyone, when they're running in with the ball, they want to take wickets for the Indian cricket team. I think these comparisons and, you know, these scenarios are created from the outside world, and that's something that we do not focus on. Jadeja takes a lot of pride in his performance. Obviously, as a bowler, he wants to pick up as many wickets as he can, but if you see, every time Ashwin has picked up wickets, the economy rate from the other end is not more than 2 from Jadeja. So Ashwin will himself tell you that, you know, Jadeja has played a massive role in him being able to make those breakthroughs, because there's literally no runs from both ends, and they bowl brilliantly in partnerships for us this whole season. And I'm really happy for Jadeja, especially with the bat, the way he's coming up. We've always believed that he's had the ability, but he himself is realizing it now, and he prepares really well to go out there and score crucial runs for the team. And, you know, he's been able to do that. So that for me has been a bigger positive. We all know how accurate his bowling is. But the biggest plus with Jadeja for the last few months, if you ask me, has been his batting. See, obviously, it's I know, I mean, we've gone through that ourselves as a team. It's never, you know, easy to, especially when you get, when you win 2 tosses, you get 400 plus, and then you have an innings defeat. Obviously, it's deflating for an opposition. I know what they would be feeling like. We've gone through the same as well in the past, so it's never easy for the team. That's all I can say. Yeah, you have to see the kind of balance he gives the side. You know, we don't rely on Jadeja as a bad wicket bowler. He's a perfect bowler for any condition in Test cricket. He's accurate, and that's what you need in Test cricket. You don't necessarily need to have variations, you know, at your disposal too many. His strength is bowling a nice pace, not giving too much air in the ball, and making the batsman think about how long they can defend. And that's his strength. On any wicket in the world, if you're bowling that accurately for a long time, invariably the batsman will make a mistake. So that's what we always banked upon as far as Jadeja is concerned. And it's only when he delivers in a massive way that these questions start coming up. You know, we thought this about him. We as a team, we always believed in him a lot, that he gives this side the balance that we require to win Test cricket. Test matches, and especially in home conditions, it becomes much more lethal. But away as well, I think he's someone that can provide that accuracy for the team. Yes, I would say it's a complete performance from the time we were put under pressure in the first game to coming back and winning the next 4 test matches, and coming from behind all 4 games. We lost 3 tosses, 4 tosses including Rajkot, and then winning 3 games out of that is very satisfying. So. Yeah, as a captain, I feel it was a complete series for us, and everyone contributed at different times, and especially the lower order contribution is something that stands out for me, you know, in this particular series. It's a very tricky situation, actually, to give yourself 20 more overs if they haven't bowled you out in almost 200 overs. You know, it's, you don't feel like saying, you know, this guy is, it's close to 300. I mean, it doesn't happen every day, you know. And it's not like he's taking 10 overs to do it. He was hitting sixes, he was hitting fours, and he was getting us a bigger lead. So it was a perfect scenario where he got us to a stage where we wouldn't have batted again. And at the same time, we had enough overs. If the wicket was doing enough, then those overs are good enough. You know, if we have 5 bowlers, then we should be able to knock teams off in 90 plus overs, and that's exactly what we did. When we've played abroad, I mean, most of the times the teams have given us batting on the last day with 90 overs and a target that's achievable. So it's all how you go about that particular situation. The good thing was that Karun really stepped it up close to his milestone, and it didn't take too long to get there. So it gave us 5 overs yesterday, and then today, this game is very unpredictable. After the first session, I'm sure you guys were not talking about all this. You know, you would have said, oh, it's going to be a boring draw and nothing's happening. And then suddenly things happen, and in test cricket, a team can lose in one session, and that's exactly what happened today.